Hello everyone. In today's tutorial, we will set up a breadboard circuit for the PIC16F628A microcontroller and download into it the LD micro code that we generated in tutorial 3. We will do a step-by-step translation of the circuit diagram into the breadboard. First, get the breadboard and place the microcontroller in the middle. Use a jumper wire to connect the upper and lower negative marked lines. Do same for the positive marked lines. Now, insert a jumper wire pin into any hole along the negative marked line and the other pin end to a hole along pin 5 of the microcontroller. Then, get another jumper wire and connect the positive marked line to pin 14 of the microcontroller. Next, connect the clock circuit of the microcontroller. To do this, insert the two pins of the 20 MHz crystal oscillator into holes along pin 15 and 16 of the microcontroller. Then, insert one of the 22 picofarad ceramic capacitors into any hole along pin 15 of the microcontroller and then to the negative power line. Insert the second capacitor to pin 16 of the microcontroller and also to the negative power line. Insert the two push button switches side by side to the positive power line and any hole above the microcontroller. Use a jumper wire to connect these switches to pin 17 and 18 of the microcontroller. Connect two 10 kilo ohms resistors, one to pin 17 and the other to pin 18 of the microcontroller and their other ends to the negative power supply line. Connect another 10 kilo ohm resistor between pin 4 of the microcontroller and the positive power supply line. To connect the LEDs, first, insert a pin of the 330 ohms resistor into a hole along pin 6 of the microcontroller. Then, insert the other pin to any hole below the microcontroller. Next, insert the anode of the LED in line with the 330 ohms resistor and its cathode to the negative power supply line. Remember that the short pin near the flat edge is the cathode of the LED. Repeat the previous steps for the other two LEDs by connecting them to pin 7 and 8 of the microcontroller. The final connections are the pins of the PickKit 3 programmer. First, insert the 6-pin connector of the programmer to the breadboard at any point below the microcontroller. Then, locate pin 1 of the programmer with the marker and use a jumper wire to connect it to pin 4 of the microcontroller. Connect pin 2 of the programmer to the positive power supply line. Next, connect pin 3 of the programmer to the negative power supply line. Then, connect pin 4 to pin 13 of the microcontroller. Finally, connect pin 5 to pin 12 of the microcontroller. Connect the USB cable to the programmer and then to your computer. With this, the circuit is ready to be programmed, but we must first download and install the PickKit 3 programmer software. You can do this with the link in the description below. Extract its contents and double-click on the setup file to start and follow through the installation process. Locate the software icon from your start menu or type PickKit 3 on the search bar to open the programmer application. From the device drop-down menu, locate and select the PIC16F628A microcontroller. Click on the File menu and select Import X. Open the location on your computer where your LD micro program was saved. Select MyFirstProgram.x and click on the Import button. Observe the change in the text on the program memory window. These are the codes that were generated by the LD Micro application. Click on Write to download the codes to the microcontroller. Finally, under the target power section, click on the checkbox beside on to power up the circuit. Now, back to the breadboard. Push the first switch and observe that the first LED comes on and goes off when released. Also, push the second switch and observe that the second LED and third LED comes on and goes off when released. This was exactly the ladder diagram behavior when we simulated it in our second tutorial. And that's all. We will repeat the same process with Arduino Nano in our next tutorial. If you like this video, please click on the like button, the subscribe button, and the notification bell on this page. See you in our next tutorial.